Empowering and promoting women in business is an absolute priority in the Trump administration because I know how crucial women are as job creators, role models, and leaders all throughout our communities. You're really an inspiration to everybody, and that's men and women, believe me. A lot of men out there, they're not doing what you're able to do.
Well, President Trump meeting with women business owners at the White House to discuss issues they are facing and what topics were addressed. And how did the president's plan, how did it relate to everybody? And what is he going to do to fix the inequity? Joining us right now is one of the women who was in that meeting, CEO and co-founder of CN Plus, Lili Gil Valletta. Thanks so much for joining us, Lili.
Thank you.
What was it like yesterday?
Well, it was a very productive session. I was very proud to represent the voice of small business owners, women, minorities, and definitely was an open forum for us to put things on the table and see if we can find solutions together.
What does your company do?
So my company is a business consulting and big data analytics firm, and we work with big Fortune 500 companies that want to successfully reach minorities as a growth market.
You mentioned a lot got done when the cameras went away. What was your, now, number one, if the president calls, you're showing up. I don't care who's president, number one. Number two is, what message did you want to get across, and also what did you hear?
So I wanted to, as a businesswoman, anchor it in a business topic. A lot of people, especially in my community, were expecting us to bring up immigration or things like that, but I wanted to talk about growth. If we all grow as a small business community, women community, minority community, the entire American economy will rise. We're outpacing the creation of new businesses as women, 2-to-1 to men. And within that group, we are leading the way as minorities. So there has to be ways to remove the barriers that get in the way of us achieving our full potential so that the economy can achieve its full potential.
One of the challenges you just mentioned to me as a woman as opposed to man is the fact when life events happen, usually more responsibility falls on the woman. A lot of times, whether it's birth or a divorce, in what way can that be addressed from the White House?
So when the cameras weren't in there, we actually talked about access to capital and some of the lending mechanisms today that are so restrictive because of regulation and how small banks are held to the same standards as big banks many times. And we are disproportionately affected because your credit score changes, your ability to earn money changes when you jump off a career ramp. And those things need to be taken into consideration because a great big idea of a startup by a woman may be underfunded because of that.
And here's the thing, too. Fundamentally, it's networking. The men, for the most part, hang around a lot more people, a lot more business, a lot more contacts. How do you foster those contacts?
You know, mentoring is very important. Actually, when Ivanka kicked off our working session, she started with that topic. So how can we match us up that are maybe in a smaller, middle size with the big guys and make it a productive collaboration, not a competition? And I think we're looking forward to some of those programs through the SBA or just by being more intentional
right.
in matching us up.
And I think that Ivanka especially is going to be zoned into the follow-up to make sure something's getting done.
Exactly. It's clear she's going to play an active role in that whole space.
And she's heading to Berlin for an international conference on women businesses.
Right.
Lili, thanks so much.
Thank you.
It was a great day, and I appreciate you reflecting on it with us this morning.
Absolutely.